Here at D3O on England's south coast, boffins have created a unique shock-absorbing material. The remarkable substance has been engineered to absorb the force of an impact, making it perfect for Winter Olympians. Molecules inside the orange goo float freely, but the moment a shock is applied, those molecules lock together, dispersing the force of the impact. Then, job done, they float apart again. To turn it into a pad, they need to mould this putty-like material into a set shape. And that calls for cool chemistry. First, this machine combines the D3O with a number of other chemicals to form a liquid. Once poured into a mould, the material expands, creating a spongy, shockproof foam. Crucially, this foam can be moulded into any number of designs. Each piece of body armour begins with a concept drawing, followed by a detailed 3D computer model. These particular designs are for a knee pad. The next stage is to turn those computer images into a prototype. First, a state-of-the-art CNC machine is used to create a mould. Once complete, the moulds are then half-filled with D3O and clamped firmly together. Within 10 minutes, they have a sleek orange protective pad, ready to take a serious battering. Next door, the D3O is put through its paces.
We're looking at the performance, what is really important, getting the testing right, but making sure they've got the flexibility as well.
And now it's time for everyone's favourite bit, testing to destruction. First it's stretched, then it's given a heavyweight hammering even the most crash-prone Olympian couldn't hope to dish out. This new pad could be all that stands between a bruise and a broken leg. So every part tested is assessed and thoroughly analysed by computer. And it's passed with flying colours. But it's not just Olympic skiers benefiting from this unique material. It's even been adopted by the movie industry.
Action.
Some stunt sequences call for performers to endure repeated blows all over their body. In the past, stuntmen have worn all-in-one protective suits.
Now, get right over top until you're praying on him. And now to give him some time, milk that a little bit.
But with continual use, parts of those suits eventually wear out. So this Zion protective Lycra clothing comes equipped with various hidden compartments sewn into the lining. These allow individual pads to be removed and replaced whenever necessary.
And it covers all the major parts: tricep, elbow, lower arm, hips, legs, knees, shins, even the coccyx. Which is nice.
Today is a major rehearsal for a show-stopping car stunt. Stuntman René Gamers makes final adjustments to his protective suit.
Every time you're going to be flying through a wall or having a car driving straight at you, there's always this little itching inside that says, well, this might not be a good idea.
With the cameras rolling, the crew run to their safety positions. Do not try this at home.
Nobody move!
You okay? Yeah, just another day at the office.
The Netherlands, a land of windmills and windbags. Here in Heerenveen, the big airbag company have been making safety bags for the extreme sports industry for 10 years. Their giant airbags can be as big as 400 square meters, allowing athletes and thrill seekers to break in their skills without breaking their necks. The company was set up by a pair of snowboarders. When designer Ion Gertsma started out, making these airbags was a long-winded process.
15 years ago, we had to hand cut all these pieces. Nowadays, we just use a CAD. There's a lot of parts, over 65 of them.
The process starts with Rob Mulder on the computerized cutting machine. He cuts out shapes in toughened PVC. The machine can cut to an accuracy of 0.01 millimeters. And yes, you're right, Rob is cutting holes in it. Not because he's angry, but because the airbag is not pressurized. Air is always going in and out. Multiple adjustable windows allow air to be forced out at high speed when a daredevil smashes into the bag. That way they sink down to safety rather than bouncing off into oblivion. Once the PVC is cut, it's taken to the high-frequency microwave welding room. This machine can fuse together pieces of PVC in under 6 seconds, without a spark in sight.
Because we're welding it, it's airtight, and it's much stronger, and it's even watertight.
The material is then moved to the assembly platform.
There are 65 pieces. It's like a big puzzle. We use a lot of stitches here because the guys who are using it, they do really mad things with it.
With the welding and sewing complete, it's then time to inflate the airbag to its operational size. To do that, they close all of the air windows and fire up the pumps.
There are two blowers, and it takes approximately 5 minutes to blow up.
And with that, the airbag is ready to be shipped out to crackpots and Olympic hopefuls worldwide. You're up, maniacs!